Hello and welcome to the John Ark Show. Today's episode is called Los Angeles is Now Worse Than the Purge. Before we begin, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our channel for free. You can also like, comment, and follow us. We're going to have a lot of great celebrity interviews coming up, so make sure to click on that notification bell so you can be notified every time we post a new episode. Also, we ask that you please post a link to today's episode on your social media so that we can help get the word out about the show. Now, let's get started. Law enforcement in Los Angeles and throughout California is now publicly saying that Los Angeles is now worse than the movie The Purge. Now, if you haven't seen The Purge, you should check it out. There are several iterations of it, and it's a stunning post-apocalyptic depiction of crime gone completely insane. And that's what they're saying about Los Angeles in real life and about California. San Francisco as well. In fact, San Francisco has been purge-like for more than a year. Los Angeles is now telling tourists to stop coming to the city because they can't protect them. And by Los Angeles, I mean Los Angeles law enforcement. And if anybody would know, these people would know. In New York, big banks are telling their employees to start dressing down when they come to work to reduce the chances of them being robbed on the street. In other words, they want their employees to look like the bums and the crackheads that are robbing people on the streets in order to mitigate or reduce the chances of their employees being robbed on the streets. Think about that. This just shows you how completely incompetent and how low the IQs are of the people running our banks. That sort of policy is completely insane. Now, women who are simply walking down the streets of these cities are routinely being knocked down, knocked out, and put into comas. Not robbed or raped, just knocked down for recreational purposes and because they're shooting videos that they hope will go viral. Now, CEOs of retailers who are having their stores emptied by the smash and grab teams have sent a letter. Listen to what these geniuses have come up with. They've sent a letter to Congress asking them to pass something called Inform. Inform is a piece of legislation which would compel online companies to make their sellers trying to sell goods online identify themselves so that if it turns out they were actually selling illicit or stolen goods, they could be tracked down. This is so incredibly, incredibly incompetent, I can't believe it. First of all, do you really think that people who clear out entire stores in a few minutes are incapable of getting fake ID or stealing fake ID or making fake ID that would bypass the algorithmic screening for the online sites which sell this garbage all across the world? Do you really think they're incapable of doing that? It's unbelievable. Do you know who else is getting hit really hard? Cannabis stores and cannabis delivery services. Some of them are being robbed several times a week. The reason they can get away with it is because it can sometimes take police hours to respond to a lower level crime like that because they have higher priorities. Now, remember the good old days when catching a criminal or a crime on video with your phone was enough to put them in jail? Not anymore. That's how things were 5 years ago, maybe 3 years ago. That's no longer the world we live in. Why is that? Because prosecutors and district attorneys don't issue bail orders, and judges also, don't issue bail orders to keep them in jail after the criminals are processed. They're simply released again and free to commit more crimes that same day. You know, you don't want to let an entire day go to waste simply because you are arrested, momentarily arrested. You can't have that. That would be an interruption of your work schedule. You want to get back out on the streets as quickly as possible and start robbing and raping and clubbing innocent women over the head. So what can you do as a person simply living your life and trying to work and stay alive? First of all, whenever possible, Drive, don't walk. Stop wearing any and all jewelry. Do not ever use your cell phone in public while outdoors or simply walking down the sidewalk, because that's a great way to get it stolen. It's a great way to get punched in the face. Also, don't walk around like an idiot wearing earphones and listening to music completely oblivious to the sounds around you. Why is that? Well, first of all, headphones prevent you from hearing the three or four people creeping up behind you getting ready to club you to death or steal your phone or all your other possessions. Secondly, talking on your phone attracts predators who like to steal phones. Next thing, we recommend that whenever possible, women should avoid walking or traveling by themselves. Walking in groups is always safer. Are you one of those very independent female souls who thinks that you can take care of yourself and that sort of thing would never happen to you? Well, if that's the case, then do a search on social media today and just watch the countless videos of women out there who get hit in the head with a brick or a rock or a club or a baton or a bottle, or who've had their babies ripped from their arms by human cretins or human traffickers or crackheads who know they can get a couple hundred bucks for your infant. That is what's going on every day all over the country. Our advice to everyone is to carry pepper spray or a taser or both if it's legal in your jurisdiction. Last and most important, you need to kill that stupid little voice in your head that says, it's not going to happen to you. That voice is your ego. It's not your brain. It's your ego and your pride. It's got nothing to do with reality. Stop thinking that minding your own business will prevent anything bad from happening to you. Because in the real world, minding your own business is precisely what attracts crazy predators. They never go after anybody who looks nuts or appears crazy. They always go after innocents minding their own business. Now here's a final thought, final recommendation for people, and that is, stop assuming that the women walking towards you on the sidewalk are a non-threat because they're just female teenagers. If you went back on social media and you saw the number of female gangs that almost kill people on the sidewalk, kill other women, kill senior citizens, kill teenage boys, you would be stunned. Never dismiss a young female or a group of young females simply because they're females. The number of female gangbangers out there is almost as high as the number of male gangbangers. With that, I want to wish you good luck. I want to encourage you to subscribe to our channel for free. You can also like, comment, and follow us. We're going to have a lot of great celebrity interviews coming up, so make sure to click on that notification bell so you can be notified every time we post a new episode. Also, we ask that you post a link to today's episode on all your social media to help us promote the show. Thank you once again, and we shall see you soon. Goodbye.